Good morning, student. Today I am going to teach you regarding fiber to fabric. On Saturday we just talked about fiber to fabric. We recapitulate the topic fiber to fabric of class 6th, and most of the things you know. So it's the same topic which we are going to do. Now in class 6th you did about cotton and jute, the natural fiber. This time also you will study about the natural fiber, that is wool and silk. You will study regarding two natural fiber, one is wool and other is silk. I have given you sub questions based on what I have shown you yesterday. I have given you some questions on that. So that is what you understand, that you will do. What do you understand by the word fleece and rhyme, where we had a little lamb? From where silk fiber comes, name some animals from which we get wool fiber. Why some animals have thick coat of hair, and why hair is poor conductor of heat. So these questions you have to do in your note. After doing these questions, we'll switch over to this activity also you will do. That you will feel your hair. Which one is coarse? Which one you feel that it is coarse? Which one is soft? You will feel that head hair is coarse. Coarse means rough. It is rough. When you touch your hair present on your head, you feel them, they are rough. But when you touch your arm, when you touch your legs, you feel that the hair present over there are soft. On legs and arms, it is soft. Clear? When you will do this activity, you have to touch it and you will understand what you are doing. Now next is, there are two types of hair, the coarse beard, the fine soft hair. Wool is made up of fine under hair, soft hair. Whenever we are selecting wool, जब भी हम कोई wool लेते हैं, wool किससे बनता है? जो soft hair होते हैं, किससे बनती है wool? Wool is made up of soft hair. किससे बनाते हैं हम लोग इसको? हाँ, very good. इसको हम बनाते हैं soft hair से. और ये कहाँ होते हैं? ये under, मतलब ऊपर की तरफ नहीं होते, they under hair होते हैं, fine under hair. What they are? They are fine. Under hair, they are soft. ठीक है, fine under hair. For this, what we do? We do selective breeding. इसके लिए हम लोग क्या करते हैं? Selective breeding करते हैं. Now, what is selective breeding? इसमें हम वो parents select करते हैं, which are having this special characteristics है, और they are of उनकी जो babies हैं, offspring का मतलब क्या होता है? Babies. What is the meaning of offspring? It is babies. So we select the special characteristic. We select the parents, and from parents we select the babies which have soft under hair. That is selective breeding. Okay? Such as comma hai iske baad offspring yahan pe aa gaya. This is comma. Such as soft underwater hair in sheep. So this is known as selective breeding. Now this is a video which I am going to play for you. Just see.
In our earlier classes, we have learnt about some fibers obtained from plants. Apart from plants, some fibers like silk and wool are obtained from animals. In this chapter, we will learn about animals that yield wool, processing fibers into wool, life cycle and rearing of silk moth. First, let us learn about the animals that yield wool. Wool is obtained from the fleece or hair of sheep, goat, yak and some other animals. These animals bear hair on their body. Hair traps a lot of air. As we all know that air is a poor conductor of heat, Hair keeps these animals warm. Wool is derived from these hairy fibers. There are many breeds of sheep found in various parts of our country. The hair of the sheep has two types of fibers that form its fleece, namely the coarse beard hair and the fine soft under hair close to the skin. The fine hair provides the fibers for making wool. The wool commonly available in the market is sheep wool. However, the fleece of sheep is not the only source of wool. Yak wool is commonly used in Tibet and Ladakh. In Jammu and Kashmir, Angora wool is obtained from Angora goats. It is woven into fine shawls called Pashmina shawls. Wool is also obtained from camel's fur. In South Africa, wool is obtained from animals like llama and alpaca.
Okay, so you have seen this video from which it is being obtained. Clear? You've seen that? Now, next step is how we do processing into the wool. Now what we do rearing and breeding. Rearing का मतलब क्या होता है? इसका मतलब होता है कि आप उसको कैसे पाल रहे हैं, कैसे आप रख रहे हैं, कैसे आप look after कर रहे हैं, how you look after that animals which you keep, है ना? तो that is known as rearing. That they breed over there, वहाँ पे वो उनका reproduction होता है, तो वो करते हैं, उनको हम shelter में रखते हैं, we give them a food, और जो food हम इनको देते हैं वो यही नहीं होता, नॉट ओनली ग्रास, ठीक है, फूड उनका ग्रास ही नहीं होता, बट वी गिव देम ऑयल केक्स, वी गिव देम कॉर्न, ठीक है, वी गिव देम ऑयल केक्स. ऑयल केक्स किससे बनते हैं? आपने देखा होगा जब सरसों का हम जब तेल निकालते हैं ना, व्हेन वी टेक आउट द ऑयल फ्रॉम द सीड्स, सो लेफ्ट आउट ऑफ द सीड्स दे आर मिक्सड विद हे एंड हस्क. That is known as oil cakes. ठीक है, we give them corn, we give them pulses because it gives them nutrient. And remember one thing, that the wool is made up of protein. Okay, the hair, they are made, even our hair is made up of protein. और जो sheep के wool हैं या animals के जो ये fleece हैं, ये भी किसके बने होते हैं? They are also made up of protein. Now we'll just switch over this video, just look at this.
In this module, let us learn about how sheep are reared, how their hair is cut, and the processing of the fibers into wool. First, let us learn about rearing and breeding of sheep. Sheep are reared in many parts of our country. Sheep are mostly reared in mountain regions like in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim, and in the plains of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat. Certain breeds of sheep have thick coat of hair on their body, which yields good quality wool in large quantities. Now, let us know about some breeds of sheep found in India and the states in which they are found and the quality of wool obtained from them. For example, Lohi breed of sheep is found in Rajasthan and Punjab, and good quality wool is obtained from them. Nali breed of sheep is found in Rajasthan, Haryana and Punjab, and carpet wool is obtained from them. Marwari breed of sheep is found in Gujarat and coarse wool is obtained from them. Patanwari breed of sheep is also found in Gujarat and the wool obtained from them is used for hosiery. Bakarwal breed of sheep is found in Jammu and Kashmir, and the wool obtained from them is used in making woolen shawls. Rampur Bush Air breed of sheep is found in Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. Brown fleece is obtained from them. Sheep are herbivores and they feed on grass and leaves. Shepherds take their herds of sheep for grazing. Apart from grazing sheep, shepherds also feed them on pulses, corn, jowar, oil cakes and minerals. Oil cakes are the material left after extracting oil from seeds. In winter season, sheep are kept indoors and fed on leaves, grain and dry fodder. Once the reared sheep have developed a thick growth of hair, hair is shaved off and processed to obtain wool from it. The hair shaved from the sheep cannot be used directly for knitting sweater and weaving shawls. Processing of this hair should be done. As a result of this, processed wool is obtained and used for several purposes.
Okay, so this is regarding this, ki how, what they are feed and what are the common breeds in India that you have seen. और जो ना समझ में आए ना, तो अगेन यू वॉच दिस वीडियो, तो आपको सारे क्वेश्चन आंसर्स भी समझ में आ जाएंगे, ये भी समझ में आ जाएंगे. नाउ व्हाट वी डू दैट, हाउ वी मेक वूल फ्रॉम फाइबर, क्या करते हैं? तो इसके 6 स्टेप्स हैं: शेयरिंग, स्काउरिंग, शॉर्टिंग, क्लीनिंग ऑफ बर्ड्स, डाइंग, रोलिंग ऑफ वूल. शेयरिंग में क्या करते हैं, जैसे शेव करते हैं ना पापा लोग, व्हेन दे शेव दे टेक ऑफ देयर हेयर, वैसे ही हम लोग शेप का क्या करते हैं, शेव करते हैं. उसमें उनकी व्हाट वी डू दैट, वी जस्ट डू दैट शेविंग. अब उसमें हम लोग क्या करते हैं, जब उनका शेव करते हैं तो इसमें क्या कहते हैं, जो शेयरिंग होता है इसमें हम लोग उनका बाल निकालने पर क्या करते हैं, व्हाट वी डू व्हेन वी आर रिमूविंग द हेयर, सो वी टेक अ thin layer of skin along with the thin layer of skin, and you know they don't feel hurt, they are the sheep or these animals, they don't get hurt, inko dard nahi hota. Kyun nahi hota? Because upper that layer is, kyun nahi hota dard? Kyunki wo jo layer hai wo kaisi hai, that is dead. जैसे आप स्किन को रेयर करते हो तो वो जो लेयर आती है वो कैसी होती है, वो डेड होती है. ठीक है, अब व्हेन वी जस्ट रिमूव दैट, व्हेन वी डू द शेयरिंग, उसके बाद व्हाट वी डू, वी अप्लाई एंटीसेप्टिक, एंटीसेप्टिक लोशन. हम उनके ऊपर क्या लगा देते हैं, एंटीसेप्टिक लोशन, एक लाल रंग की दवा लगा देते हैं, जिससे अगर कोई इन्फेक्शन, दे गेट सेफ फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शन. Now what we do, the what is the second step, what we are doing is scouring. In scouring what we do, we wash the wool, yeah, which is the sheared fiber which we have taken, kyunki usme kya hota hai, mitti bhi lagi hoti hai, kahin kahin jate hain to seeds bhi lag jate hain, the hooked wale wo atak jate hain, dust hota hai, dirt hota hai, to hum kya karte hain, inko washing tanks mein le jate hain, they are washed, aur 8 baar isko wash karte hain. Then सेपरेट दिस फाइबर्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर टेक्सचर, कि मतलब वो सॉफ्ट टेक्सचर है तो उसको अलग कर देंगे, कोर्स है तो उसको हम अलग कर देंगे. ठीक है, टेक्सचर स्मूथ है, रफ है तो अलग करेंगे, स्मूथ है तो अलग करेंगे, लाइक दिस. आफ्टर दैट व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, दैट वी आर रिमूविंग बर्ड्स. अब उसमें से हम लोग बर्ड निकालते हैं, या तो आप कोम्ब से उसके बर्ड निकाल लीजिए, दैट कैन बी डन. उसमें फ्लफी बर्ड्स कहते हैं, बूर हिंदी में क्या बोलते हैं बर्ड्स को, दे आर नोन एज बूर. तो बूर हम उसमें निकाल देते हैं. ठीक है, मोटा मोटा होता है, देन इट इज, तो उससे क्या होता है, जब वो बूर निकल जाता है तो दे बिकम वेरी स्ट्रेट. ठीक है, आफ्टर दिस व्हाट वी डू, द फिफ्थ स्टेप इज दैट वी आर डूइंग डाइंग, मतलब उसके बाद हम फाइबर्स को फिर से, अगेन इट इज स्कॉरिंग इज डन, देन दे आर ड्राइड. आफ्टर दैट वी आर डूइंग द फिफ्थ स्टेप, दैट इज डाइंग. वी डाई these fiber into different colors. It can be brown, it can be black, it can be red, or so many different colors are there. We are doing that. Then rolling of wool is done. The fibers, they are strengthened out, उनको सीधा करते हैं, comb करते हैं, and then they are rolled into yarn. जब yarn बन जाता है तो उसके बाद हम उससे क्या बनाते हैं, we make pullovers. What we are making? We make pullovers. Pullovers. Pullovers means खींच के पहनना, shawls. Then we are making shawls. We are making fabrics. What we make? Fabrics. So all these things are made by this. So these are the six steps. So what are the six steps of processing fibers into wool? Shearing, scouring, shorting, cleaning of burrs, dyeing and rolling of wool. Clear? ठीक है, ये छह steps हैं. Listen to this.
In Australia, there are more than 75 million sheep. That is more than 3 sheep per person. Sheep are domestic animals, which means they have been tamed to live alongside humans as pets or as farm animals. Sheep can live on big farms with thousands of other sheep, and once a year they are shorn so they can stay cool during summer, and their fleeces can be made into many different products. To make these products, including sweaters or jumpers, firstly, the sheep grow their wool. That white fuzzy hair isn't actually hair, but is naturally grown wool. To care for the sheep, you need a nice big paddock with lots of grass, water, sunshine, and shade. Sometimes sheep live in huge paddocks with thousands of other sheep on big farms in Australia. Once a year in spring, the sheep get their yearly haircut, where the shearers, who are special people whose job it is to shear the sheep, cut or shear the sheep's fleece. While the shearers are shearing, other workers are sorting the fleece and packing them into bales to be sold. The wool can either stay in Australia or be sold overseas. Once you are ready to use the wool, you need to give it a nice wash to make sure it is nice and clean. There are big machines that can do this, and it washes the wool up to 8 times. Once the wool is dry, you need to comb it like brushing your hair, but this is also done by a big machine. This brushing of the wool is called carding, and it removes all the sticks, thorns and knots from the wool. It is then straightened into a nice, long, thick, woolly roll. Instead of staying white the whole time, you can dye the wool into many different colours of the rainbow. You can even make a mixture of different colours. The wool is then spun. This is where the wool is twisted together to make a long, strong rope, which is called a yarn. The machine then joins the yarn together by weaving or knitting, and turns it into clothes, curtains, blankets, socks, carpet, and even your beanies and scarves. Sometimes you can see your mum or grandma doing this with their knitting needles or crochet hooks. Once the item has been machine knitted or hand knitted, you then get to wear your nice, warm, comfy, new woolly clothing, or snuggle under a nice, warm, woolly blanket. Once you're finished with your wool clothes, they can be recycled by unwinding the yarn and made into new clothes or other items. Nice and sustainable. Wool is very important to Australia, as you can use it for many different things, all supplied by the one little animal on the farm, the sheep.
So this you have seen ki how that is taking place, how the process is taking place. I have shown you a little bit ki how sare kaise hota hai, kaise dhulte hain, kaise kya hota hai, kya nahi hota. This you have seen. Up lastly, what you have to do?
In Australia, there are more than 75.
Now there are questions which you have to do. What is the food given to reared sheep? From which breed carpet and woolen shawls are made? Explain the steps of processing of wool. एक बार फिर आप इसको देख लेना, नहीं समझ में आएगा तो आप इसको फिर से कर लीजिएगा, ठीक है? ये मोटिवेशनल थॉट है आप लोगों के लिए. This is all about what we are doing.